Given an equation y double prime minus 2xy prime plus y is equal to 0. So solve this differential equation using power series. First of all, let's take a look at p of x and q of x. So p of x is equal to negative 2x and q of x is equal to 1. So you can see clearly that x equals 0 is an ordinary point. Okay, so the solution for this one is given in this form. Oops. Y is equal to the power series from 0 to infinity, cn x to the n. Right? The next step is to take the derivative of y. So y prime is equal to cn, bring down the exponent, subtract the exponent by 1, and then this power series starts from 1 to infinity. If you start at 0, when you plug in n equals 0 into this one, it will make it become 0, and that causes this issue. So you have to make n start at 1, okay? Now take the second derivative. So we have cn, n times n minus 1, x to the n minus 2, bring down the exponent, subtract the exponent by 1. Now this time n start at 2 instead of 1. Okay, because when you plug in 1 into this one, you will make this become 0, okay? Right? Now, we're going to plug these into this one. Okay, let me move this up here. Right. So we have double prime, which is a power series from 2 to infinity, cn n times n minus 1, x to the n minus 2, minus 2, negative 2x times y prime. So y prime is this one, and negative 2x times this, I'm going to bring the x, I'm going to combine x, this x and this x together, which makes it become x to the n, okay? So I have power series from n equals 1 to infinity, cn, don't forget constant number, 2cn, n times x to the n, just n, okay? Right? Now, the next series is plus y, which is power series from 0 to infinity, cn x to the n is equal to 0. Very good. Can squeeze it into this one. Let me move this over here for now. Right. Now, we're going to solve this differential equation. First, take a look at the exponents. We need to find now what is the biggest exponent. So when you plug into the max x equal 0, plug in 1, x to the first, plug in 0, x to the 0. So x to the first is the highest exponent. So you remember now terms for this series and this series. Okay? So for this one, let me change color pen here. Okay, I'm going to use a blue pen. Okay, so remember now, one term for this one. So the plug in 2, so we have 2cn, 2c2, x to the 0, which is 1, plus series from 3 to infinity, cn, n times n minus 1, x to the n minus 2. And minus, I want to keep this the same because we just rewrite it. Okay. Now for the last one, I'm going to write out one term for this one. That is, looking 0, I have c naught x to the 0, which is 1, plus series from 1 to infinity, cn x to the n. Oops. Erase this. Gosh, that's ugly. Equals zero, okay? Now, what we are going to do next is we are going to reindex this. So the reindex this power series. So we have n equal 3, n equal 1, and n equal 1. Most likely, I'm going to reindex this to reindex this because I just do 1 instead of doing 2, okay? Alright, write it out here. So reindex it to 1. So I lower 2, that means I'm gonna increase 2 for every single n inside here. So I have n plus c, n plus 2, n plus 2, n plus 1, x to the n. Okay, and then don't forget to cross this out because I'm this replaced with that. Alright, now what you're gonna do next is you're gonna combine like terms, okay? So I have constant here and constant here. So I have C0 plus 2C2 plus. Now, after, if you notice, after you index, you're gonna have n start at the same number, which is 1, and x, you're gonna have x to the same power, which is x to the n. So I'm gonna factor that out, x to the n. I'm gonna factor out x to the n and put it at the end, okay? So plus the power series from 1 to infinity, as always, big bracket. C n plus 2, n plus 2, n plus 1, minus 2 c n, plus c n. All multiplied by x to the n is equal to 0. Okay, it's down here, right? Now let's move this up. Alright, now we are going to require coefficient. So, constant c0, c0 plus 2, c2 is equal to 0, then c2 is equal to negative c naught over 2. Okay, now c n plus 2, n plus 2, n plus 1, minus 2 c n times n plus c n is equal to 0. Now solve for the biggest c n. So we have c n plus 1, 2, c n, c n. So I'm going to solve for c n plus 2. So c n plus 2 is equal to 2cn times n minus cn divided by n plus 2 times n plus 1. So you add 2cn n and subtract cn on both sides. Now n is starting from 1, 2, 3 all the way to infinity. Okay, and when n equals 1, c3 is equal to 2 times c1 times 1 minus c1 over 3 times 2. Simplify this gives me C1 over 6. No, I like to leave it as 3 times 2, okay? N equal 2, so we have C4 is equal to 2 times C2 times 2 minus C2 all over 4 times 3. Simplify this gives me 4c2 times 2, 4c2 minus c2 is 3c2 over 4 times 3, so this cancel out. And c2 is equal to negative c0 over 2, so negative c0 over 4 times 2. N equal 3, so c5 is equal to 2 times c3 times 3 minus c3 over 5 times 4. Simplify this gives me 2 times 3 is 6, 6 minus 1 is 5, c3 over 5 times 4, this drop out, c3 is c1 over 6, so I have c1 over 4 times 3 times 2, sorry, okay, So our solution is c1 equals c0 plus c1x plus c2x squared plus c3x cubed plus dot dot dot. So plug in c1, c0, c1, c2 here into this equation, we get c0 plus c1x, because we only c1, plus c2. So c2 is equal to negative c0 over 2 times x squared plus c3, which is c1 over 3 times 2x cubed plus c4, which is negative c0 over 4 times 2x to the 4th c5, which is c1 over 4 times 3 times 2x to the 5th plus dot dot dot. Now factor out. So let's take a look at this c0. So factor out c0, and we have 1 minus 1 half x squared minus 1 over 4 times 2x to the 4th plus dot 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 plus c1 parentheses x plus 1 over 3 times 2x cubed plus 1 over 4 times 3 times 2x to the 5th plus dot dot dot. So this is our final solution for a differential equation. Okay, that's it. I'll see you next time.